Since the Oculus Quest 2 arrived on the market, the world was taken by storm. The little headset was able to bring amusing and very exciting games to the VR platform, and the hype and the success kind of cast a shadow on the PC VR market as a whole. Hey, Ty here, so welcome to the VR channel. So in this video, we can understand together if the Oculus Quest 2 actually killed the PC VR market. Is there any reason to buy PC VR in 2020? Is the Quest 2 the final VR headset? Should we even compare these two markets? Well, let's discover it together in this video. Let's get into it. Alright, here we are. So I had this video in the back of my mind for a while, but I was really triggered by this latest period with the reviews on the Reverb G2, the headset with a super high resolution that is finally arriving to people after a very long wait. And I saw many people polarizing on why should I get it if there's a Quest 2 on the market that is much cheaper, it's kind of the half price of the Reverb G2, and why should I even consider the Valve Index? Now, this is not going to be a comparison between the HP Reverb G2 and the Oculus Quest 2 or the Valve Index and stuff like that, because this is not really the point. We have finally more choices on the market, and we have different price points right now. We have a very low price point with the Oculus Quest 2 at $299. We have, for example, the HP Reverb G2 at $599. This is a mid-tier headset, if you want to call it like that, and then we had the top tier with the Valve Index at $999. But there are two main reasons why at a certain point we kind of wonder if the Oculus Quest 2 actually killed the PC VR market. And the first reason is actually in games, because the Oculus Quest 2 has a standalone headset. That means they can play a wider range of games without the need of a PC or a console, and the games over there are actually pretty good and are very, very enjoyable, like with every other headset on the market. Because at the end of the day, when you are in VR, you are in VR, let's face it, it's always more immersive than anything else. And having a graphic is a little more cartoonish, well, makes it, of course, a lesser graphic experience, but it's still enjoyable. But now, the problem over there is not really how much the Oculus Quest 2 is capable in games, but actually the fact that the Oculus Quest 2 may have corrupt a little the market right now, because at the little price point, many people jumped on it, and we know for sure that the market share of the Oculus Quest 2 is much wider than the market share of PC VR headset, with companies that made the same amount of money in one day than what they made in an entire year on the Oculus Rift platform, for example. So that's why devs are trying to push games on the Oculus Quest 2 to make, of course, more money. And who gets that money drives the market, right? But that comes to the little problem, is that you don't want to destroy, of course, the VR market, so you want to keep everyone together. And games like Population One do this very well, because you can play together, or Onward as well, you can play together between the PC VR version and the Oculus Quest version, and it's just amazing and super enjoyable. But at the same time, I was in the beta very, very early on, and the game got a very big downgrade, because it wasn't supposed to go to the Oculus Quest at the beginning, but be just a PC VR game. But having to go to the Quest version, they had to downsample the graphic, make the graphic a little simpler to be able to run even on a mobile device. And this pattern is something that we see in different games that kind of keep down the graphic to don't really have to choose between the Oculus Quest version or a PC version, but make the big VR community. And now this is great for the community, but on the side, yes, it's kind of killing a little what is PC VR, because at the end of the day, we're never gonna see like an Half-Life Alyx arriving for the Oculus Quest. And of course, games are gonna be more enjoyable on PC VR when it comes to graphic and stuff. But on the same time, many games are actually just not even trying to push the PC VR market because they don't get enough money from it as much as they get from the Oculus Quest 2 version. So yeah, that's kind of a problem in the problem over there. Now, the second point that I want to make is about the headsets themselves. Now, we have the Oculus Quest 2, that is an amazing headset, and really, I'm always trying to be super honest during my reviews because there's really no gain for me to like protect a brand or the other. At the end of the day, this channel is for you guys, it's not for the companies that like make headsets and stuff. I'm super glad that they send it over to review because you guys are interested, and that's my position. I receive them, I review them for what I think, and you know, if I started to bring out lies and stuff or overhype stuff, I will never feel good for myself, because then things come out later. So that's why I was triggered by the reviews of the HP Reverb G2 to make this video, because I was super honest during my reviews, and you can see that I showed the downfalls and the good things of these headsets. But at the same time, I saw people putting on the table the Quest 2, that you shouldn't get it because the Quest 2 is there, and well, I think that that is completely wrong, of course. Now again, the Oculus Quest 2 is an amazing headset. When it comes to value, it's really kind of unbeatable. At $299, you have a complete experience. Yeah, it's not the most comfortable. It doesn't have the best audio. It doesn't have the best graphics. It doesn't have the best screens. But it kind of have everything over there, that you can even connect it to a PC and play pcvr, that is really hard to don't suggest. And in fact, if I have to suggest an headset to somebody to start in VR, I will tell them get an Oculus, because everything is good, you can really enjoy it, there are many stuff and software that are completely enjoyable, and you don't have the problem of using a PC. If you want to use it, you use it. If you don't, well, you have great games already over there. But at the same time, when I compare it with the HP Reverb G2, for example, or the Valve Index, well, things start to fall apart, because on a G2, yes, it's double the price, but you have an audio solution that is absolutely amazing and is worth $100 by itself. You have two 4K display and state-of-the-art lenses that make the clarity unbelievable when you compare it to the Oculus Quest 2 as well, even playing pcvr games over there. And of course, being a pcvr headset, it doesn't have all the batteries and stuff inside, so it's much lighter and smaller than the Oculus Quest 2, and so at the end of the day, it's even more comfortable with better material and stuff, a better strap and everything. So at the end of the day, if you add it up, everything to make the Oculus Quest 2 kind of the Reverb G2, well, you have to add the cost of the cable, that is $70. You have to add the cost of the strap, that can be $40 or $110 if you want a better balance with the battery strap. Good pairs of headphones are very expensive and stuff, and $100 more, so at the end of the day, you're pretty much the same price, and you have something that didn't come like that out of the box. Now, does it mean that it's not good, it's not worth it? Absolutely the opposite. But when you start to compare these headsets, everything starts to get a little tricky. So I really urge people to stop to polarizing stuff and compare the Oculus Quest 2 with the Reverb G2 and stuff. Everyone has his own market, and I think that everyone really deserves that price. Now, of course, I would like to see a price drop for the Valve Index, but I think that now the market has really took a shape where we have a mid-tier, an high-tier, and a low-tier, and that's just good for us. They have more choices to make. So at the end of the day, did the Oculus Quest 2 kill the pcvr market? Well, in reality, no. But I feel that the internet and these talking around and hyping stuff really kind of like starting to breach on it. But let's make it clear, this is not the reality. A pcvr headset that does pcvr right now, and for now, is gonna be always better than a standalone headset that also does pcvr. But at the end of the day, yes, every experience is still good enough to be enjoyable, and we have to consider that. So look at your priorities, look what you want from an headset, and decide. And I make my videos with all the different reviews of all the different headsets, so you're able to get take the right decision. But let me know in the comment below what you think about this situation. Do you really think that Oculus Quest 2 is killing pcvr also for the games, as we stated in the first part of the video, or even as an headset, it's like doesn't make sense anymore to get other headsets like the Reverb G2 or the Valve Index and stuff? Or do you think like me, that everyone has his own little market, and kind of comparing is like not really enough sense, but more like picking on stuff to say, oh, mine is better, mine is better, mine is better, like the VR console war or something like it, even if it doesn't exist? Let me know in the comment below. I'm really interested to see your ideas, and I really wanted to make this video because for me it's very important to bring out my opinion on this situation. But anyway, guys, let me know what you think about it in the comment below, and as always, if you liked the video, like, if you didn't like the video, dislike, subscribe to the channel for more of VR tech. And if you really love the channel, there's a join button down there. A little further, also the Patreon with prior access to videos and different videos as well. And at the same time, we have the t-shirt, the sticker, and mask 2020 item number 1. But again, like, dislike, subscribe. See you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.